Hey guys, it's Kira with Crofty Cosplay, and welcome back to another Shadow of the Tomb Raider tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how I created the harness for the quiver and knife sheath. I tried to keep this as simple and affordable as possible, but still make it close to the reference photos. Taking some craft foam, I made strips about 12 inches long and roughly 2 inches wide, rounding the corners. I painted these the same tan color that I used on the quiver and sheath, and let them dry. I like the idea of using the craft foam because it would sort of act like padding and remain durable after painting and sealing. I wasn't really sure how many slits were in the padding strips of the harness, so I decided to just add one in the center. I made a rough measurement, then carefully cut the slits, as you can see here. I made sure they fit the extra strips I made out of black craft foam, which are there for an added layer of durability. I then glued the black strips down before coating the entire thing with some Mod Podge. Then I took some 1-inch nylon webbing and fed through some of the hardware to make this harness look a bit more legit. I added a 1-inch slide and a 1-inch ring. I glued the webbing down without weaving it through the slit, but I do suggest weaving it through because it will make it more sturdy. Then I proceeded to cut and glue the webbing to the ends of the ring, as you can see here, before gluing the rest of the strap down. You want to every now and then test the harness around yourself to make sure you're gluing and cutting down to the right length. One of the pads should be over your right shoulder and the second pad under your left arm along your side. So once you have the right length, add another ring and then a buckle. I glued all of mine down, but you can certainly create this to make it functional. Once the harness is complete though, it's easy to slip right over your head so your buckle doesn't have to actually work. After I glued the rest of the strap down, I decided to add another slide before gluing the last bit of the strap to the shoulder pad. Again, make sure you're testing this around yourself before gluing things down so you'll be sure that it fits. After, I cut another strip of nylon webbing. This will attach to the front and back of the harness to rest over the left shoulder. Before gluing anything, I put the entire harness on and attached the strap with some clips to measure the proper length before attaching it. Now the harness is done, but I had to attach the quiver and sheath to it somehow. You can do this however you want by sewing or even gluing them on, but I decided to go with Velcro so that I can easily store this prop later on. In some cases, depending on how heavy the quiver and sheath are, Velcro may not be strong enough, but it worked fine for me. And although the Velcro I had was adhesive on the back, I still glued it down to make sure that it stayed. Place your knife into the sheath and fill your quiver with arrows, and it's all done. As I said, you can easily slip it right over your head or make the buckle actually functional. It's entirely up to you. Thanks again for watching this cosplay tutorial. Feel free to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already and follow me on social. I'll catch you in the next video. Bye!